ball line in hand. Okay, we're ready. So we're currently motoring towards the B&A for the flyby there, and then we're going to head up to the start line. Wind is doing probably 14 knots south southwest. We're heading to Sea Point first, then down to Woodbridge, and then it's out to sea. Next stop, Rio. We have Dom's mom on board today. It's her birthday.
Hi guys.
Right, it is our first day, first full day at sea. Max is on the helm. Max, how's the first day been?
It's been very good. A little bit of no wind at the start. That's fine. We overtake a bunch of work now, which is nice and good. Now it's time to race because we actually need at least a few knots.
Nicely after lunch on day two. Well, we haven't actually had lunch yet. Josh and I just finished packing away one of the snows, and everyone else is taking a nap.
Too tough to talk with nothing to fear. We'll kick it out of you. We'll beat you black and blue. Don't be surprised if you don't last a year. All of the madness continues. To haunt me. Hello world, this is me, and I'm more than gonna be
just one of the boys.
You're gonna be famous, son.
One of the boys.
And your life has just begun.
One of the boys.
You'll make it to number one. Open your eyes.
Just one of the boys.
Welcome to the club, my son.
One of the boys.
Right here is where you belong.
One of the boys.
So we're flipping through the HF channels to find the weather bulletin from Cape Town Radio, and we ended up finding Cape Talk instead. Pretty cool.
Let's try to do a radio interview.
Now, please.
You'll be the catch of this. I failed the subject. In my matric
here. Oh, this is our man.
It's, what's his name? Yes, it's
Lester. Lester. Lester.
So,
definitely, I parked. Woo! Day two of Cape2Rio 2020. We are out here, it's a beautiful day. We're swimming. Woo! How psyched is everyone at the moment? Psych levels? I think psych level is about 7 right now. Yeah, let's go for a swim, boys.
Life that sadly stuck again. Wish I was much more masculine. Maybe
it's not gonna be. this.
The lighthouse beam has just run out. I'm cold as cold can be.
It is day three of the race and we are cruising along at 7-8 knots with the Jenica up. Josh, how are you feeling?
Great. Cruising. Very fast. Nice wind. Yeah.
Oh. I love this place so far. This ship so far. Sure. We're heading, what, nine knots.
And
with Joshua on the Jenica seat, this was 100% loving it all the way.
We've had the Jenica up since about 8 o'clock this morning. And we've been cruising along all day. It's been very nice. E3 of Cape2Rio 2020, and it has been absolutely amazing day. We've flown the bag for most of the day. We've been screaming along at
8 knots, 8, 9 knots. 10.6, baby! You and I! High five, up top.
Yeah, it's been a very rewarding day at sea. The crew was a bit tired today. We had a long night last night. All in all, it's been a very good day.
And would we just appreciate beautiful sunset we got this morning? This evening. Yep!
Something special about the night watches. For 2 hours every night, it was just you and your watch partner, solely responsible for the lives of everyone on board. The boat isn't just a boat, it's something that along with your crewmates becomes the center of the earth. We started sailing in a more westerly direction. We encountered an amazing following sea with strong winds behind us. We were averaging boat speeds of 8 to 9 knots and completing up to 186 nautical miles in a day. This was some of the best sailing of the race that we had.
Right, it is 7:45 South African time on the, I don't know what day of Cape2Rio, we're on 12th day, something like that. We are about to cross Greenwich Meridian. Matt is on the helm, he's going to take us over the Meridian. The rest of the crew are down below at the moment, getting ready to come up for the crossing. Yeah, Matt and I get stuck with the double ship because we're going to set our clocks back 2 hours. Alright, so we just dropped the spinnaker after the wind picked up a bit, and it was a very smooth takedown, and Josh was standing by here in the hatch ready to pack it straight into the bag, nice and slick, except he didn't realise that he'd packed himself into the spinnaker bag while packing it away.
You know what? I think it suits me.
How fast is he?
Yes, baby!
Yes, Max!
Do you have the knot?
Wait, Joshy, let's get this. Yeah, I know what I'm doing with the gaff, my China!
You can see right through his arm, right?
Mikako, how's it going?
Yo, wind picked up, rain picked up, we've got a storm coming. Yay! Good for us because we need this wind.
Now,
yeah.
How's the motion of the ocean?
Rest my life up here. We got the purple bag up. Oh, come on. Oh. Yep, purple bag's up. Bag out. Yeah, it's a lovely day, it's quite gusty, quite sick. Woo.
day 17 of Cape Fear 2020. Watching a majestic sunset over the ocean. Here it's been a lack of time, just chilling with the people. It's really amazing. Enjoying the trip so much. Not too much wind, but still having a great time.
Max, come here.
Max, go the right way.
The swell's building up, picking up now, the wind's pulling in. We've had a whole day of wind, no wind.
Really, really hot.
And we're gonna watch the green flash now.
And then we're gonna tip upside down on the car.
Please don't.
And the green flash will signify good wind, a bit of swell, and getting to Rio in 25 days.
What?
Yeah! Not from now.
Yeah.
In total.
Yeah.
Max! That's to your problem!
We have just had a lucky swim. good to clean ourselves off after so many days of constant heavy wind. Unable to get really clean on the boat. So it's nice to get in the back in the water.
Alright, it's morning of day 20 of Cape2Rio 2020. We have a stunning sunrise of our stern coming from the east. What is absolutely amazing these days is having sunrise in the back and the sunset of the front as we sail into the west. Last night was quite eventful. Just before midnight, we got the Jenniker and we took the Spinnaker up. And then around 12:30 in the morning, it was time to drive onto a new waypoint. So the Spinnaker had to come down because our pole was broken, so we can't drive the pole. So the sail was dropped, we dived, re-hoisted and continued. Then at about 5 o'clock this morning, we had a wrap up on the Spinnaker. That came up pretty quickly, so that was good. And now we've dived the Spinnaker again after dropping it, and we're sailing west. We went further southwest last night to get on a better point of sail. And now this morning we're heading further west again towards a group of islands. But yeah, our current ETA to Rio, it's the 22nd of Jan, so we're hoping to get in by the 30th, 31st, so we're in the final stretch now. Some days some do more workouts than others, and on some days no one does anything. This is the first time we're seeing some exercise in a couple days.
I do it all every day.
No you don't.
No, you don't. I do.
No you don't. Alright, on day 23 of Cape2Rio we have finally spotted land for the first time. Woo! So just off the bow here, you won't see it in the footage, but we have two little islands that we are currently approaching. We're about 20 nautical miles away from the first one. And then the second one has a cliff height of 599 meters. We can just see that dipping on the horizon. Matt and Dom went up the mast this morning to take a look and see if they could find it. Dom at first thought it was an oil tanker, but it turned out to be the mountains that we were looking for. So yeah, there's much excitement on board at the moment. We're getting much closer and closer to Rio.
So the islands are coming into view now. We just put the Spinnaker up and in a couple of hours we're going to be turning further south into Rio, well, to Rio. So yeah, it's pretty exciting. We're going to probably hit them and see them at nightfall up close, so the crew's pretty pumped for this.
Shortly after we passed El Trindade, we found ourselves stuck in a high pressure that we couldn't outrun. The prospect of having to retire from the race, as we wouldn't be able to make it to Rio in time for prize giving, was becoming very real. When it was time to make a decision, the crew refused. They were determined to keep sailing until we couldn't anymore, even if it meant arriving in Rio at the final hour.
It's quite sad knowing that we almost maybe four or three days out of Rio, and it's very sad seeing this journey come to the end. But what's cool is that I think the sunsets we're starting to appreciate a lot more, and we've set up this like a hammock and we're literally watching the biggest sun I've ever probably seen. It seems like it's right over there. Super crazy.
Nick didn't speak much in front of the camera as he went about being a skipper, but I couldn't have asked for a better friend to co-skipper this race with. Having grown up together as scouts and having been the patrol leaders for some of the crew, this race was very special for us.
Alright, so for the last couple days of having almost no wind, last night it was breeze on. We had wind of 15 to 20 knots, gusts peaking at 16, 17. We flew the spinnaker throughout the night. It was only dropped just before 6 o'clock this morning. We made some really good ground. In the last 24 hours, we did 155 nautical miles. Unfortunately, it doesn't seem like it's going to be enough to get us into Rio in time still. But we're going to see how today goes. It's the 31st of January, 2nd of January is the cutoff. So we are absolutely sending it through the South Atlantic at the moment. We'll see how it goes. We're
going to
get this everything we've got until the last moments.
It's the final countdown!
Unfortunately, not even this final blast of breeze was enough. The race cutoff was 1200 hours on 2nd of February. With about 40 nautical miles to go until the finish and around 0300 on the morning of the 2nd of Feb, we made the decision to retire. The wind had dropped off completely and was forecast to stay like that for another 24 hours. After 3 hours of struggling to start the engine, we engaged it into forward. At that moment, the race itself was over for us, but that didn't take away the adventure that we still had to complete.
What's that? What?
It's land ahoy!
Land ahoy!
Land!
South America!
Yeah!
Alright, so 30 days later, over 4,000 nautical miles, and we are finally in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Yeah!
30 days at sea, we are finally at Sugarloaf Mountain in Rio de Janeiro.
Yeah!
Yes!
Now to make the port turn towards the yacht club, the engine failed. So we're busy getting a tow in from these guys over here. We've got less than an hour to go to prize giving, so it's going to be tow in, hit the showers, get changed, hit prize giving, and then party time, and we'll sort out the broken engine. We'll be right back. Alright, so this is our final vlog together as the 2020 Cape2Rio crew of Rotary Scout. We are currently at the Yacht Club in Brazil. It is, what's the day today? It is the 7th of February. Yeah. It's our last night in Rio. Josh and I are sleeping on board Zulu Girl tonight. We set sail for El Grande tomorrow and are sailing back to Cape Town on Zulu Girl. It's an opportunity we got at the last moment and that we just simply couldn't pass up. We're very pleased that we're not flying home with the rest of the team and ending off this all together. But yeah, I suppose it is what it is. Yeah, it's a very surreal moment saying goodbye to the lads now. Months and months and months of preparation boiled down to this final moment.
It's quite a crazy day. Let's say goodbye to Rotary. Just realize now it only hit us. I think it's done.
Yeah, the return crew set sail today.
Saying goodbye to driving. Good night. Thanks to Dominic.
Next race, there we come. See you then.
All the while, it's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.